Kimberly here from thepeacefulmom.com, and today I wanted to share my 4 top tips for rocking your morning. So to get started, I know that some of you are night owls and not morning people, and let's be honest, it's not going to change your entire life if I tell you that you need to get up at 5 in the morning. You know, that is not the magic pill that's going to fix everything. We both know that's true. So I do have a few tips that will help whenever you get up. So I just want to encourage you. I'm not telling you that you have to get up at a specific time, but I will say that the number one tip is to get up before your children. And I know I had 4 children, 5 and a half and under. So I understand having a lot of little kids and how difficult it is to get up before they do. So if that is your situation, you might try a little preemptive strike, plan ahead a little bit and have a snack that they can eat while they're watching a video so that you have a little bit of time to get yourself together before you have to start helping them get ready. And another option is to have a box or basket of toys that are only for morning time. And that will give you just a little bit of time to get yourself together before all the craziness starts. My second tip is to start the night before. Your morning can be made so much better if you will do a little prep and pack the night before. So if your kids are going to school, you can put lunches together and stick them in the refrigerator. You can make sure that everything that goes in the backpacks is in the backpacks and waiting by the door. If you work outside your home, you can gather all of your work papers or anything that you need for work and put it in your bag by the door. If you like to go to the gym or work out, go ahead and set those clothes out. Go ahead and get your clothes out for the day so that you don't realize first thing in the morning that the blouse that you were planning on wearing with that skirt is actually at the dry cleaners. So all those problems can be solved the evening before when you're not in such a time crunch. Next tip is to make sure that you are getting enough sleep. Sleep is so important, and if you are going to bed really late but you have to get up really early, there just isn't enough time for you to get rested, and you're probably living off of caffeine, and it's a really hard cycle to get out of. But I just really encourage you to try to have a bedtime routine that is soothing and calming at least an hour before you're ready to go to sleep. You know, turn off the electronics and read a book if you want to take a shower at night, or do something that soothes you like a cup of chamomile tea. That's what you need to do, is to make a routine that will help you to get to sleep better. So my next tip is to have a routine, and your morning routine needs to be really, really simple. So I like to start by getting a glass of water, and I put the water on to make some hot tea. I'm not really a coffee drinker. And then once I have my drink, I do a 5-minute brain dump. And this is basically just output, where I am unloading my brain, what dreams I remember from the night before, things that I need to do, emotions that I need to process, if there's anything that I'm still thinking about from the day before. So I want to get all of those things out on paper, and I actually do something called morning pages, which was first created by Julia Cameron in the book The Artist's Way, and I've mentioned it in videos before, but basically you do stream of consciousness writing for 3 entire pages, longhand, handwritten. And that really helps me, but I don't want you to start there because again, you need to keep your morning routine simple. So just start with a 5-minute quick brain dump on a piece of paper. Then after you have that five minutes of output, you want to have 5 minutes of input. You want to read something or do something that's going to energize you and set you in a positive frame of mind for the day. So that might be reading a positive book. It might be reading the Bible. It might be memorizing some scripture. It might be listening to music. It might be watching a coaching video, or I like to do a little bit of artwork in my art journal, and I will show you a little sample. So I'll work on the page, on a page, for a few minutes every day, and I really enjoy that, and it energizes me. find something that will help you get your day started on a positive note and do that for 3 to 5 minutes. Then the next step is to organize your day. And I like to use the Joyful Life Planner. And I've mentioned it before, it's a planner that I created myself. And the new planners will actually be coming out soon. And the new design has the hour by hour scheduling. And there's a place for your morning routine at the top or your top three for the day. It's a really great idea to increase your productivity by choosing those three top things that have to be done. Now, we all know there are a bazillion things that can be done in a day and probably a half a bazillion that need to be done. But you need to choose the top three absolute make or break, these have to be done or there are dire consequences. And I also like to include in that list one item that's moving me along towards a long-term goal. So you have your morning drink, you have 5 minutes of output, 5 minutes of positive input, a quick organizing of your day, and then the last tip is to include some movement in your morning. So you might do 5 minutes of stretching or a couple of yoga poses, or you might, like me, take a quick walk. I walk my dog every morning. You could do an exercise video. Anything that will get your blood pumping and help you to wake up and face your day in a positive way. Another tip, if you are a work at home mom, then the next step would be to work on something that is something that you've been procrastinating on. You might have heard that quote that's attributed to Mark Twain, but we're not sure he actually said it. Something along the lines of, if you must eat a frog, eat it first thing in the morning. And I'm sure that I completely butchered that, but the idea is whatever is most difficult, you want to do that first thing in the morning and get it over with. So those are my tips to help you have a wonderful, happy morning. And I would love to hear from you what one small change you'll be making this week to make your mornings better. Remember, you can find me at thepeacefulmom.com and beautifullife365.com, and I'll add some links into the video description with some helpful resources. I hope you have a beautiful day.